Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Aaron Cohen. I'm a neurosurgeon with a special interest in surgical management of hemifacial spasm through microvascular decompression surgery. I would like to this evening, through this live webinar, review some of the basic concepts regarding diagnosis as well as medical and surgical management of hemifacial spasm, after which I'm more than happy to answer your questions and also review some of the questions that you have previously submitted. Hemifacial spasm is characterized as involuntary intermittent twitching of the muscles of the face, which is usually unilateral. Spasms typically originate around the eye and later spread to other muscles of the face. It can be triggered by stress, fatigue, and some cutaneous stimuli. And often the patients complain that when I'm stressed, I tend to have a lot more spasms, which bother me more, and I'm fatigued the same way. So this is a picture of a patient of Harvey Cushing, the father of modern neurosurgery, obtained in 1920s, very well illustrating how if you are touching the face or you have two cutaneous triggers, the patient will have spasms. And as you can see, it's very clear the spasms in the right side of the face and especially around the eye. So why is hemifacial spasm so important? Well, it's disfiguring. It interferes with normal expression of the face. It interferes with vision. And it affects about anywhere from 0.8 to 8 per 100,000 folks. And most importantly, it's just embarrassing for the patient. You know, people always look because you think you're winking or you're sort of making unusual facial expression. So it's cosmetically disturbing to the patient. This is a very good friend, a patient of mine, who has kindly agreed for me to show the pictures. And as you can see on the left side of her face, there is evidence of hemifacial spasm. As you can see, it is very disfiguring. It really caused a lot of discomfort and distress for the patient. This is her picture after surgery. As you can see, a pretty smile, which obviously makes my day and makes doing this practice for me very satisfying and rewarding. So what causes hemifacial spasm, folks? A blood vessel compressing the vessel or sort of touching the vessel at the level of the brainstem in the back of your head, just behind your ear. The vessel sort of causes misfiring of the nerve and therefore sort of over contractions of the muscles that are controlled by that nerve on your face. It's similar to trigeminal neuralgia, which is face pain, which is cranial nerve 5. However, that's mostly a sensory nerve, and therefore it only causes pain. Injury to the nerve, a tumor that could compress it, or Bell's palsy, a history of Bell's palsy, could also cause hemifacial spasm. But for the most part, we're talking about really a vessel, a normal vessel in your brain, behind your ear, deep in your brain, touching the nerve that goes to your face, irritating it, and therefore causing some over discharge of the facial muscles because the nerve is irritated. So how do we diagnose hemifacial spasm? It's a clinical diagnosis. We see what the twitchings are, how they started, where they go. Occasionally they start on the lower part of the face and then move up to the eye. And then we do an exam. And then the imaging study of choice is an MRI. And as you can see in the arrow in this MRI, there is a vessel that's compressing the nerve coming out of the brainstem right there. And therefore, that vessel causes irritation of the nerve. What are the medications that we use often? Tegretol, Dilantin, sometimes muscle relaxants. However, most of these cause drowsiness, balance difficulty, nausea, and therefore the patients are not very fond of them. And often the patients try to look for and seek other options. The second most reasonable option is botulinum toxin or Botox. You guys all have heard about it. It's pretty effective.